are 70 kilometers apart on highway. So here is point A, here is point B, and they are 70 kilometers apart from here to here. A car starts from A and another car starts from B simultaneously. If they travel in the same direction, that means if this car travels like this and this car also travels like this, they meet in 7 hours. Say they meet at some point here, Q point, and this takes 7 hours. But if they travel towards each other, first we'll concentrate on the first condition, then we'll go to the other condition. So see that if we assume that the speed, because we have to find the speed of two cars, let us say the speed of car A is X and speed of car is Y, kilometer an hour, kilometer per hour. We know speed equal to distance by time. So what will be distance? Distance will be speed into time. In the first case, if X is the speed of A, or the car starting from A, then it takes 7 hours to meet. So how much does it travel? 7 is the time, that is time. And what is the speed? That is X we have assumed. So it is 7X. Okay. Now Y for Y, Y for B, Y is the speed. And again, 7 hours it takes to meet with A. So how much distance does it travel? Speed is Y. We have assumed it to be Y. Time is 7 again. So it is 7Y. Now let us see. What will be this AB distance? AB distance is this AQ minus BQ. We subtract this distance from whole of this distance. We get this distance. This is 70. So this 7X, which is the distance traveled by A, from A, car from A, and distance traveled by B is 7, this distance. So we have to subtract AQ. If we subtract BQ from AQ, we get AB. So if we subtract AQ, AQ is what, 7X? BQ is what, 7Y? If we subtract, we get the distance is 70. So this is our first condition. So we are assuming X and Y as the speed, car starting from A to B, A and B, X kilometer per hour, Y kilometer per hour. Now distance traveled by car X is AQ, by Y is BQ. The distance traveled is simply speed into time, so 7 into X and here 7 into Y. But we know by geometry this AQ is AB is AQ minus BQ. So 7X minus 7Y equal to 70. We divide whole equation by 7. We get X minus Y equal to 10. This is our first equation. Now let us come to the second part. But if they travel towards each other, so again, this is A and B. Now, this car is traveling this side, this car is not traveling this side. So now they meet at Q here when they are traveling towards each other. Again, this AQ plus BQ is this AB, which is your 70. What is AQ? The speed is X, and the time they have given is 1 hour. Means both travel for 1 hour. So X into 1 is the distance covered from A, distance covered from B is Y into 1. So AQ is X into 1 plus BQ is Y into 1, that is Y, and this is equal to 70. So we have X minus Y equal to 10 and X plus Y equal to 70. So just add them, this gets cancelled. 2X equal to 80, X equal to 80 by 2, that is 40. And what will be Y? If you put X as 40, so Y has to be 30, then only you get 10. So Y is 30. So speed of first car from A is 40 km per hour. Speed of second car is 30 km per hour. A sailor goes 8 km upstream in 40 minutes and return in 1 hour. Determine the speed of the sailor in still water and the speed of the water. So now just understand that this is the stream, that is some water, canal or a river. Now the sailor goes 8 km downstream. When the sailor is sailing downstream, the stream is also in this direction. So let us assume that the speed of sailor in still water is X and speed of the current is Y. So X is the speed of sailor and Y is the speed of the current. So speed will be added x plus y will be the relative speed. Now, when this is another condition, when the sailor is in the opposite direction, that is x, and the stream is in this direction, so it has to work hard to overcome this y. So this has to be subtracted from x. X minus y will be the relative speed when he is going, or the sailor is going upstream. So whenever this question comes, we will take the upstream as x plus y and downstream as x minus y. X is the speed of sailor or a swimmer or anybody in the still water, and y is the stream of the water, that is actually the current. Okay, now we know that speed equal to distance by time. Okay, now sailor goes 8 kilometer downstream, so 8 kilometer is the distance in the first case. This is the distance, and what is the time? Time is in 40 minutes, so 40 minutes is the time. So let us take time as distance by speed. The distance is this, speed is what? When it is going downstream, the speed is x plus y. And this is equal to 40 minutes. 40 minutes is what? We divide it by 60 to get it in hour. Okay, 40 by 60, which is 2 and 3. 22 is a 40 and 23 is a 60. So you get 2 by 3. This is our first condition. 8 by x plus y equal to 2 by 3. The second condition is this. It returns in 1 hour. When it is returning, it is going upstream. So again, the same distance will be there, 8 kilometer. 8 kilometer is the distance, and x minus y in this case will be the speed. So x by x, 8 by x minus y, distance by speed is what time? So time is what? 1 hour for now, 1 hour. So you get 8 equal to x minus y. So x minus y equal to 8 is one condition, and 2 fours are 8, 4 threes are 12. So for this 12, x plus y. X plus y equal to 12 is another equation. Add these two equations, y gets cancelled. 2x equal to 20, x will be equal to 10. If you put x here, say 10, y has to be 2. So now x we have assumed to be the sailor's speed in still water, which is 10 km an hour. And y we have taken as the speed of the current, which is 2 km an hour. So 10 and 2 is the answer. A boat goes 30 km upstream and 44 km downstream in 10 hours. So we are given the time. So this time total is T1, which is, you can say, I will just write upstream, TU. TU, that is upstream, plus TD, that is TD downstream. So total time is 10 hours. TU is the time for upstream and TU is the time for downstream. So this time is 10 hours. And if we assume, determine the speed of the stream and the boat in still water. Let us assume the boat in still water, the speed is x and the speed of stream is y. So as we have seen in the previous question, the time is nothing but speed is distance by time, time is distance by speed. Upstream, the speed will be x plus y. Upstream speed will be x minus y. Downstream, it will be x plus y. So this is for upstream, and this is for downstream. This is speed. Now we know that time is distance by speed. So what is the distance in first case? 30. And what is the speed? We assumed it to be, when it is going upstream, it is x minus y. So x minus y plus. Now TD, time for the downstream. Downstream, the distance is given as 44 km. And the speed for downstream is x plus y. Because when you are going downstream, x and y will be added. When you are going this way, x and y will be subtracted. X is the speed of boat in still water, y is the speed of the stream. So first condition is this one. Okay, now the second condition is, it in 13 hours, again 13 hours it can go 40 km upstream. So 40 upstream is x minus y. This is your TU. And what will be TD in the second case? 55 km by, it is downstream, so x plus y. So these are our two equations. First is 30 by x minus y plus 44 by x plus y is 10. Then we have 40 by x plus y plus 55 by x y equal to 30. Let us put 1 by x plus y equal to u, or you can say 1 by x minus y rather equal to u, and 1 by x plus y equal to v. Why we have taken x minus y? Because x minus y is coming first. That is why we are taking it as u. So the equation becomes 30, 3u plus 44v equal to 10. 44u plus 55 equal to 10. You can bring 10 here so that it becomes minus 10, and 13 also here, so it becomes minus 30. Now you can do, you can solve u and v using the cross multiplication or any other. This is the solution in front of you. U and v will come as, u will be 2 by 10 and v will be 1 by 11. Now equate this by 1 minus x, y, we equate this with 1 by x plus y. So you get x minus y, that is 2 into x minus y equal to 10, and then you have x plus y equal to 11. Now you need to solve these two equations. You will get x as y as 3 and x as 8. So x was the speed of boat in still water, which is 8, and speed of stream is 3. You just have to solve these two equations. I hope that you'll be able to solve this. A boat goes 24 km upstream and 28 km downstream in 6 hours. So now I'm directly doing it. 6 hours is the total time. The total time is what? Total time is nothing but TD plus TU. That is time for downstream and time for upstream and time for downstream. So 6 is equal to 24 and upstream. 24 is upstream. We are taking upstream. That is, we are taking X as the speed of the boat in still water and Y as the speed of the stream. So when it goes with the stream, it will, the speed will be x plus y. When it goes against the stream, it will be x minus y. So 6 will be equal to, the time will be equal to, time is distance by speed. So distance in the first case is 24. The speed upstream is x minus y plus. Now TD, that is time for downstream is 28 km is 28, and then downstream x plus y is there. Okay. So this is first condition. Second condition, let me write it here. It is 6.5 hours. 6.5 is nothing but 65 by 10. You can write it as 65 by 10, or you can write as 6.5 is simply 30 by 60, which is 6 plus half, which is 6 to the 12, 12 plus 13, 13 by 2. So 13 by 2 is the time. So 13 by 2 will be equal to, this is T will be equal to TU plus TD. TU is what? The time upstream. So 30 upstream, x, the relative speed will be x minus y, and then 21 by downstream, so x plus y will be. So this is our first, second equation, this is first equation. So let us now put 1 by x minus y as u, 1 by x plus y as v. So you get 24 u plus 28 v minus 6 equal to 0, 30 u plus 21 v minus 13 by 2 equal to 0. Now this is the solution in front of you, this we have solved using the cross multiplication. So essentially you are getting u equal to 1 by 6, v equal to 1 by 14. So now put 1 by x minus y equal to 6. So x minus y equal to 6 will be our another equation. Now put this equal to 1 by x plus y. So x plus y equal to 14 will be our another equation. You need to solve this. 2x will be equal to 20. X will be equal to 10. Put x here, 10. So y has to be 4. Y will be 4. So speed of stream, that is 4 km an hour, and speed of boat is 10 km an hour. A man walks a certain distance with a certain speed. If he walks half kilometer an hour faster, he takes 1 hour less. But he walks 1 kilometer an hour slower, he takes 3 more hours. Find the distance. Find the distance. Now in this case, let us change from our track and we'll not use x and y. We'll just say that the rate at which he is walking is r, right? The rate at which he is walking is r, and the second thing is the time he has actually walked. So time, and this is rate. So when you see, the distance is what, you know, speed equal to distance by time, and distance is speed into time. That is, in this case we have taken speed as r and time is t. So what is the distance he is covering? Rt. In any ways, from this point, the distance will be RT always. But first condition is this: if he walks half kilometer faster. So if R is the rate, if we add half kilometer more, that is if he walks half kilometer per hour faster, he will take 1 hour less. So T is time. So let us subtract 1 from here, 1 hour less. But this will remain as RT because the distance will remain same. This is the distance. The distance remains same. The time has increased by half hour. The rate has increased by half hour. Time has decreased by 1 hour. When we multiply these two also, we will get RT only. This is our first equation. The second equation is, but he walks 1 kilometer an hour slower. So if we subtract 1 from the rate, he will take 3 hours more. So we have to add 3 with the time. T plus 3. Then again, the distance remains the same. This is distance. It will remain same. RT equal to this one. So first is, this half can be written as 0.5. So R plus 0.5 into T minus 1 will be equal to RT. This is RT into minus R. That is RT minus R 0.5 T minus 1. So this comes, RT, RT gets cancelled. You get an equation R minus 0.5 T equal to minus 0.5. The second is RT equal to R minus T into T plus T. So this will be RT 3R minus T and minus 3. So this gets cancelled. You get another equation like this. So when we solve these two equations, and it is pretty easy, just this is also a linear equation in terms of R and T. R will come as 4 kilometer an hour and time will be 9 hours. So R is 4, time is 9, and distance will be what? See, distance we took as R into T. It has to be 4 into 9, that is 36. 36 kilometer hour, 36 kilometer is the distance. A person rowing at the rate of 50 kilometer an hour in still water takes thrice as much time in going 40 kilometer upstream as in going 40 kilometer downstream. Find the speed of the stream. Now here, what we are being provided is, let us say that x is the rate of water in which it is flowing. So x is the speed of the stream, right? Now the first condition is, the person rowing at a rate of 5 kilometer in still water, in water, takes thrice as much time in going the upstream. So when he is going with the stream, that is x is the speed of the stream, and he is going at 5 kilometer, that is phi is his speed. So the relative speed will be x plus 5. Now when he is going against the stream, phi is his speed, x is the speed which is against it, so the speed, sorry, it will be phi minus x. This will be phi plus x. So phi plus x, when he is going along with the stream, phi minus x is the speed, relative speed, when he is going against it. The question is saying, the person rowing at the speed or at the rate of this much in still water takes thrice as much time in going 40 kilometers upstream. So when he is going upstream, that is d, let us take distance is d from here to here. So d by phi minus x, phi minus x is the relative speed when he is going downstream. The question says, when he is going downstream, it is 3 times when he is going upstream. So this is upstream, which is say d by say phi plus x. Okay, we know time is distance by speed. So this is distance by speed is time. So actually the question was, t upstream is equal to thrice t downstream. So time upstream is distance by phi minus x, and td, that is downstream, is distance by phi plus x. So we don't have to do anything, because you know, see, there is some certain things given, but we don't need it, because we know eventually d is going to be cancelled. So this will be phi plus x will be equal to, this phi plus x will be equal to 3 into phi minus x. So 3 into phi minus x. This will be equal to 5 plus x equal to 15 minus 3x. Now let us bring 3 here, 5 here. So you get 4x equal to 20. X will be equal to 10 by 4, that is 2.5. 2.5 kilometer an hour is the rate of the current which we assumed earlier. Ramesh travels 760 kilometer to his home partly by train and partly by car. So here we assume the speed of the train is x kilometer an hour, and speed of car as y kilometer an hour. He takes 8 hours if he travels 160 kilometer by train and rest by car. So the total time he is taking is, sometime he goes by the train, so we write TT, time in train, plus TC, that is time in car. We know speed equal to distance by time, time is distance by speed. Okay, so time in the first case it is given as 8 hours. So 8 hours is equal to time in the train. Time in the train is what? We have assumed x as the speed of the train. So speed of the train is x. So let us x, take x in the denominator, which is speed. Now distance is what? He takes 8 hours if he travels 160 km by train. So 160 by x is the time taken while he in train. Then total distance is 760. He travels 160 by train. So how much he travels by this car? 760 minus 160 that is going to be 600. So now 600 is the distance he traveled by car, and we assume that speed of car to be y. So this is our first condition. 8 is equal to 160 by x plus 600 by y. So this is equal to 8. This is equal to 8. So you can divide whole equation by 8, 8 and 8. You get first equation as 20 by x plus 75 by y equal to 1. Now let us come to the second part. He takes 12 minutes more. 12 minutes more means 8 hours plus 12 minutes more. So 12 minutes, let us change it into hour. So this is the time, and time will be what? Total time will be equal to TT plus TC. Time taken in train. So he travels 240 km by train. So 240 by x plus x is the speed of the train and y is the speed of the car. So how much distance he covers by car? We have to subtract 760. 240 with 760, what do you get? 0, 2 and 520. So 520 by y. So this is actually, you know, 6 to the 12, 6 tens are 20, 2 5s are 10, 1 by 5. So 8 plus 1 by 5, 5 is 40 plus 1, 40 plus 1 by 5, that is 41 by 5 is the time. So let us write 41 by 5 here. So this is our second equation. 240 by x plus 520 by y is 41 by 5. Now these are two equations in front of us. Now we can just solve it also sometimes. You know, you can just say 40. You can divide whole equation by 40. So 40 into 6, 40 into 13, and 40 into 5 is 200. So you get 6 by x plus 13 by y equal to 41 by 200. Now take 1 by x as u, 1 by y equal to v. So our equations, when we solve these two equations, we get u equal to 1 by 80. So we have taken u as 1 by x, so x is 80. And v, of course, is 1 by 100. We took 1 by y as 100, so y is 100. So now 1 by 100, that is y is 100. So what do you get? The speed of the train is 80 km an hour, and speed of car is 100 km an hour. What we have to do here is just simply, this is first equation, this is our second equation. You just have to solve this equation and you will get the answer. A man travels 600 partly by a train and partly by a car. So let me just write the equation. See, the total distance is 600 km. And we know that time total will be equal to time in train by plus time in car. So total time given for the first case is 6 hours 30 minutes. So 6 hours 30 minutes is what? 6 plus 30 by 60. So I am changing it into minutes. Hours. 6 plus half. So that is 6 to the 12 plus 1 by 2. That is 13 by 2. So total time is 13 by 2. Now time is for the train. We know that time is distance by speed. First distance is 400 km. So 400 km, what is the speed of the train? Let us take it as x, speed of the car as y. So 400 by x is the time taken while he was in train, and time taken while he was in car, it will be, see, 400 he has traveled, 600 is the total distance, so 600 minus 400, that is 200 he traveled by the car. This is our first equation. Second equation is, but if he travels 200 km by train, so 200 by train and rest by car. So subtract 600 from 200 from this 600. So 600 minus 200 is 400. So 400 he travels by car, and y is the speed we assume. Now what is the time? He takes half an hour longer. So that will be 6 and half plus 30 minutes, that is 7 hours. So these are two equations. You have to take 1 by x as u, 1 by y equal to v, and you can just solve these two equations. Here is the solution in front of you, and then you get the v and u as 1 by 80, 1 by 100. Just invert them. 80 will be your x and 100 will be your y. So speed of train is 100 km an hour. Speed of car is 80 km an hour. So this is the first part of this specific topic. We'll be taking one more part of this. Thank you so much. Take care of yourself.